I know pretty crazy weather out there, but the clouds are shining on us, the roads are clear, and the safe travels to this beautiful building today. I want to thank the mayor and Warwick for allowing us to use this beautiful facility. We'd like to open this up by welcoming the Warwick Fire Department and letting them post their colors.
Thank you, Gina. is honored today to be able to provide this gathering space for everyone to come together to take part in the observance of a fire, as we remember those who were lost, we recognize those who were injured, and we pay tribute to the families of our community and beyond who will be forever affected by this tragedy. I'm honored to be joined today by Fire Chief Ed Armstrong, City Council President Donna Travis, and Peter Ginaitt, who you will hear from shortly. Peter is one of our own, who is not a member of our fire department, who was among the first to respond to the scene. And it is only fitting, as Gina said, that, you know, as we were out last night, late into the night with the snow swirling around, trying to figure out how we would make sure that we got the roads cleared, but we also got the parking lot clear and everything done here so that the steps were shoveled and everything was ready. And as you know, it's only appropriate that we're coming through a bad, stormy night into a beautiful sunny morning. The irony of that is not possible. The memorial that is located behind our annex was constructed to give families, friends, and survivors a place to reflect and to remember. And I hope, too, that it has been a place to gain a small measure of solace and peace. And this is also a time to recognize all of our fire and police personnel who responded that evening, as well as the numerous volunteers from so many agencies who either staff the center at the Crown Plaza or the Days of Cholera, who assisted the state, our communities, and our families in the days immediately following the fire and still do today. And I want to thank all those who were involved in organizing today's event for giving us an opportunity, most importantly, to come together and to come together in remembrance and in celebration of loved ones. And please know that all of the victims, all of the first responders in the community at large continue to be in the thoughts and the prayers.
We need everyone to be positive and to want to be a part of this beautiful, uplifting place or something so tragic happened. Please, if you have any concerns or questions, contact us in the right place in the right moment. We are hosting an annual meeting on March 24th at the Warwick Public Library at 6:30. Please come and express your concerns or ideas. We are open to listening to everyone. We want this to be about our community and our 100 families. It's not just the board. We're here to represent you. But we're the ones that have to go forward with the construction team. So come visit with us on the 24th of March and express your concerns and your ideas. But today is truly about our 100. As you all know, I'm a survivor. I lost someone incredibly dear to me that night, just as you've all lost someone, friends, families, boyfriends, husbands, whatever. That night holds for you. We're all here for the same purpose, to honor our 100, and that's what this is about. I am blessed to have such a great team of people behind me. But today I really need to thank Bonnie Hoisington, Jody King, John Howell, Sarah Manzini for helping us put this beautiful memorial service together. Couldn't have done it without you. The board is so busy with construction. It takes an army to put all of this together. And really,
just
I know also what all of you are going through.
develop the statewide hospital capacity system, we know at any given point in time how many, what the capacity of hospitals are from the EMS vehicle, what they can take for critical patients. Rhode Island Hospital and the Office of Emergency Preparedness awarded $5 million to develop an inpatient tracking system that's in every one of the EMS vehicles in the state, and in many cases, every hospital in the state. Something that has never before happened. We have new and better critical incident stress management systems. We have a statewide communication system. We found that night that radios, communities could communicate with one another. We could be standing next to one another, but with different radio systems that you were probably, Chief, correct me if I'm wrong, but you were better off yelling across the parking lot, because we didn't have a means to communicate. That has all been satisfied. Again, the safety of the fire laws, we have a new burn center. Most people don't understand Rhode Island Hospital has just been recently credentialed to be the regional burn center, providing burn care, critical burn care for the region, not just Rhode Island, southeastern Massachusetts. We have helicopters that fly in quite regularly into Rhode Island Hospital. But we've also gone, and I think the federal government has learned too, is that we have to be regional. We can't just live in our own little microcosm. We can't just think that we're going to survive within Rhode Island. But the resources that are over the borders are so critical. So those communications I talked about now cross borders. Burn care crosses borders. We would transfer burn patients from Rhode Island Hospital to Pittsburgh via helicopter, which is also part of a mutual aid plan, seamlessly to get them, instead of what happened the night of the fire, which were good doctors picking up their cell phone, calling a friend of theirs who was a burn surgeon in Boston and saying, hey, I need help. Did it work? Yes, it did. Is it the best way to do things? Probably not. And I think Dr. Charlton can do it again because he's very good at that. But I think what we wanted to key in on was the silver lining to this horrible, horrible tragedy. And while we come here and we look towards the memorial, which we so look forward to seeing, Gina, wow, I take my hat off to you and all of the volunteers because the commitment is absolutely second to none. But I think we need to turn. We truly need to never forget, but I truly believe that we need to move forward. We need to see how we have made changes, how we can make changes, and how we make sure that those changes stay. Because many times, years pass on, people are very quick to say, well, let's lighten up in the business community, or let's do something that really puts us back to where we were. And I think it's all of you here collectively tonight, and it's us and our citizenry that's responsible for making sure that this continues to happen, that we just demand that we still have and remain one of the safest states in the country. So we know it doesn't solve a lot, and when I do look at this, I parallel it to one of my life experiences at the hospital, and that's been dealing with organ donation. And a family loses a loved one. The horror on their face, the tragedy of that loss is something just many of you can equate to. But what happens after that, when an organ is given to somebody critical need and a life continues, very, very much synonymous to us making sure that we have better responses, that this won't happen to somebody else. There is a silver lining to this awful tragedy. Many people may never understand that, may not agree, but truly I do believe that we are a better state. And I thank all of you for that. The fact that you filled the auditorium here still shows that this is an important issue.
So.
At this time, we're going to begin reading the 100 names of our beautiful angels and anyone who has wanted to volunteer to come up and read some names. Come on up.
Judith Manzo, Thomas Marion Jr., Jeffrey Martin, Tammy Lee, Tammy Matera Hauser, Kristen Lahore, Jonathan Jones, Sammy J. Osella Jr.
At this time, we would like to welcome back the Warwick Fire Department to retrieve their colors.
Thank you.
like to welcome Reverend Robert Marciano.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we bow our heads this day to remember with fond devotion those whom we lost in the tragic fire of the station nightclub. Time hasn't begun. Days and years have gone by, but our hearts are still heavy, for we miss them greatly in our lives. We remember, too, those who struggled with illness and pain from that fateful night. The injured, the families, and the heroes of police and fire and medicine, who did all they could to save those in peril. Lord, we have seen such great tragedy, but we've been touched by even more goodness. As we fulfill our pledge to never forget them, we remember each one of them, and with their spirits still with us, we ask for strength in our weakness, so that we can face tomorrow with hope in our hearts, and with your peace in our lives. For you are now and always our Lord and God, forever.
Thank you so much. Thank you for taking this time and spending it with our family. We appreciate it.